We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hello, how's everybody doing? Happy Sunday out there. Welcome to Gospel Rhythms.
What's up?
Hey, this is Ro Williams.
I'm Ro Williams, and this is
Trisha Mann Grant.
And this is GospelRhythms.com, Talk Live Radio on LATalkLive.com. Happy post-Thanksgiving
Day.
Woo, girl, how was yours?
Okay, I ate, and then I ate, and I kept eating. I ate some more, and I conquered. That turkey, let me tell you something right now. And the dressing, and I had some beans, greens, tomatoes, potatoes, chicken, turkey.
Oh,
you name it. Yes, I had it all. I know y'all so sick of hearing that joke. You know, I actually went and looked up the whole video that Shirley Caesar did. Let me tell you something. The word that she gave was amazing. It's like the whole message of it. You guys should go check out the message.
Why don't you break it down?
Of it. Well... I would break it down, but I'm not going to do that right now.
Because you want you some beans, greens, tomatoes.
Because I really do want some beans, greens, tomatoes, potatoes. But you know what? It really was. It was good. So I want everybody to go look at it themselves so they can get their own awesome message from it. Yeah, I went to church today. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Pastor Sanchez had an awesome
Give
message,
Give us the
too.
Word.
Let me tell you, he was talking about, I went to church. So Pastor Sanchez was saying, you know how Moses died.
This is our guest.
Is that Jesus calling?
This is our guest, actually.
Oh, okay. That's the guest calling. He's coming. He's
but he
on
hung
the way.
Up. Yeah, yeah.
But he just hung up on the row. But he's on the way up, so that's great. His name is Herb. Awesome guy. I can't wait to actually meet him.
I
She's been saying wonderful. I didn't say his last name.
No, they know because I actually put it on
it
Facebook. Yeah, I'm actually putting out an APB on all our peeps, too. You know, where are our people at?
Okay.
Trawick.
There we go. Herb Trawick. He's on the way up. And so Pastor was talking about Moses and how after Moses died, that's when God told Joshua, hey, go on, take everybody and y'all go ahead into the promised land, because the promised land was actually not promised for Moses. He had to die. And so Pastor Sanchez said, we have to let our dead situations go on ahead and die. Stop trying to revive them.
Wow.
Stop trying to speak life and bring life into something that's supposed to be dead so that we can move on and elevate to our next situation or our purpose and our promise that God has us. You know what? I know it's in Joshua. And so had I actually written it down, I could tell
how you gonna come.
I'm just a bad Christian today. I'm a bad
and not have nothing
today
from the
bad.
Refrigerator yes. to get. I'm just like, you know what?
I sat here and I turned to Joshua and I was looking at him. I'm like, that's not what I read today. What did I read? Lord help me, Jesus. I thought it was Joshua 1. That's so sad. No, Joshua's back this way. I know
Joshua 1.
I learned,
maybe?
Like, I went to Bible study when I was a little girl and I learned Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua. Judges. Yeah, I learned
what
all
does
that.
Joshua 1:9 say? That might have something to do with what y'all learned today.
Are you actually knowing what Joshua is saying? Did you
Joshua
1:9?
Go on, look it up.
Oh, what?
And meanwhile,
just give me a scripture.
The teaching at our church
I'm
this
so
month is grace.
You.
And
is,
we
is
must
really?
Extend grace
sure.
to everybody. Even the lost.
Even the
especially
ones,
the lost.
Even the ones who should know the scripture
lost in
that
the
they
word.
Just learned a few hours ago.
Any theologians out there, please give us a call at 323-473-3100 that can lend an assist. I think we need an assist. I'm feeling the spirit of the Cowboys in here right now, and they losing, even if they win.
I'm sorry. Is she really doing this right now? Is she really trying to bring up the Cowboys?
I'm just
First
soccer.
Of all, not only did I find Joshua 1:1. But the Cowboys are 10-1, so that means that we've won 10 games out of 11.
That
and
don't
only
have
lost
nothing
one by
to do
points,
with
I think.
The word.
So thank you, Richard.
Rich,
he knows, he understands.
Oh, I
That's
see you after the show.
He's giving love to the Cowboys.
Okay,
are you really bringing up football right now? I'm trying to.
You,
I'm trying
I was
to
trying to divert. I was just. I was trying to help you out with the diversionary tactics.
I don't need divergence. movies up in here right now. Thank
diversion,
you.
Diversion.
All right, so look here. Let me read this here. Let me read this here. Come on now. All right, Joshua. After the death of Moses, I can speak. The servant of the Lord said to Joshua, son of Nun, Moses' aide, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River into the land I'm about to give to them, to the Israelites. So, you know, Pastor was saying we got to be brand new in Jesus' name. Go for the brand new. Right. Get rid of the dead.
Right.
And that the vacancy will be filled by us. The vacancy that since Moses died, now Joshua came and filled that vacancy and led them into the promised land. And don't speak life into dead things and dead situations. If you have a dead relationship and that person does not give you all of them the way that you need them to, then let that dead relationship go so God can bless you with someone that's going to treat you the way you should be treated. Even if it's
Amen.
A dead friendship, stop bringing dead friendships back to life when there's a reason they died in the first place. If that person is jealous or hateful or stabs you in your back all the time, why do you keep hanging on and holding on to that?
And sometimes that looks like they're not jealous, they're not hateful, they just use you as a utility or a convenience.
Yeah,
they don't offer anything of value. There's no exchange.
So
it's not to say that every friendship or every relationship, business or love relationship, you have to look what you can get. But you should definitely, there should be a symbiotic exchange, of healthy exchange of what am I adding a value to your life? What are you adding a value to my life?
Mm-hmm.
How am I being a support to you in your dreams and endeavor, mm-hmm. vice versa?
Right. And that goes for any relationship, whether it's marriage, business, boyfriend, girlfriend, whether it's, just any type of bond that you have with someone.
Right.
You got to make sure you guys treat each other the right way. All right. Do what's good. So, yeah, there it is. You guys, Joshua 1, so you can check it out yourself.
I'm glad I can help you. But what does the ninth verse
find
say?
This.
Just out of curiosity.
You just really want to hear about this ninth verse?
I led you to it.
Did you lead me to the ninth verse?
I led you to Joshua
Praise
chapter 1.
Jesus. You sure did. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Now, that's a word for you, huh?
That's a word for everybody. I got that on my wall. Actually, above my dresser,
above
my closet.
You look at it every day.
No, because, but it reminds me to be cloaked in his confidence. And, you know, I put it above my closet because, you know, hey, I have to get dressed in his confidence, because sometimes you wake up and you may be tormented by the things you potentially have to face. It could be just the workload, not necessarily tormented, but overwhelmed, mm-hmm. you know, by the undertow. You get sucked in the undertow of just life and its responsibilities. And you just got to know God put 24 hours in a day. You know, I can only do what I can do. And
yes.
it's just like in him, I woosah, I find peace.
Aww.
So there it is.
What does woosah mean? Does it mean chill, relax, peace, be still? What is the translation of woosah?
It just means woosah.
Just cool out.
Pump your brakes. That's what it means.
We have to look that up. Can you Google that?
We can Google that. But I just want to. I just have one question. Who am I this week?
Answer.
Am I a Williams or a Grant? Because last week, if
you
were here on the
definitely
show,
not
this one here was off the chain.
A Grant.
Thank
you,
Ty
definitely
Snow.
Not a Grant today. Ty Snow, it was so much fun having you on the show last week, and I apologize for thinking that you were a sex ed teacher and not a
special ed teacher.
Special ed teacher. I see what had happened, y'all.
She didn't meet before
the show. I heard him tell her, and I thought what he had said was, I'm a sex ed teacher. And so then in my mind, I'm thinking, oh, that's really interesting. He's just choir director and a sex ed teacher. That, now, that's some topic of conversation there. So when she said it in the show last week, and then I said, no, he's not a special ed teacher. So I was real special at that moment. I said, he's sex ed teaching, so we lost it.
But for those of you that are even wondering, who is Ty Snow?
You just had to bring that up.
He actually was on Fix My Choir, and he had a wonderful story about how, you know, here he was this monster choir director, and how, you know, the journey that the show took him through, although it was a reality show, was very real, and some of the things that he learned and was able to his takeaways from that experience and how he has grown. And they had a benefit performance, his Ty Snow and Extreme Purpose concert on November 19th. So at the Victory Bible Church. So we pray that that went wonderful.
Did you? Oh, you didn't go.
No, I didn't go. I wasn't able. No, I remember I told you I had already stacked obligations for that day. So I didn't make
it. Man. Well, we hope it was awesome, Ty, and all your students that were listening and saying crazy things about me making goofy comments. So yeah, God bless you all the choir members. You know, now that's a reality show, Fix My Choir, that I wouldn't mind watching because they're actually healing. There isn't a bunch of stupidity and drama and trying
to
bring out. But what I'm saying is they ended with some real, they ended with some real healing. It's always going to be drama in reality shows. But that's why I really don't.
I love reality shows, you know.
I know you.
But I can guarantee you that even with their healing, there's probably a bunch that walk away and it's more mess. But needless to say, in his story that was for God's glory, it wasn't that way.
I like that. You always come up with these cute little sayings.
Well,
and
you
stuff.
Know, go, I just can't help myself. The Williams plantation, you
Williams,
know, from the Williams
not
plantation.
Grant. Yeah. Yes. I don't know why did I call you a Grant.
Well,
look, why did we call you a Grant last week?
Because it was crazy. No, you had your husband on. He calls in while he knows she does the show.
But you answered the phone.
Exactly. Because I was like, do you not know where your wife is at 4 o'clock?
You didn't have to answer the phone.
I had.
You had my mind all discombobulated.
You know, because he kept texting me these evil threats about the game that
and
was going
was right,
on.
Because anyway. Your team lost, so he prophesied that thing.
You're lucky.
He spoke it. And it came
on that
to pass.
Note, we speak that you get
some greens, beans, potatoes, tomatoes.
No, bring them to the studio.
Lamb.
Look.
You name it.
You name it. You call, you tweet, you Instagram, you Facebook. This is our entertainment edition. We have music industry legend in-house, Herb Trawick. And we want you to join the party. Facebook, Instagram, tweet.
Please. SOS. Smoke signals.
Knock on your neighbor's door. Use your phone.
Mental telepathy.
However y'all communicate nowadays. Snapchat.
Speak it. I'm Trisha Mann Grant.
I'm Roe Williams.
It's going to be a fun day. We love you guys. Thanks for joining us. And stick around. We're just going to take a commercial break. We'll be right back. Downcast and the broken hearted. Changing lives with the truth. So let's get it started. We got the word. Music, entertainment, life. You can catch us on the air every Sunday night. With special guests, the news, and interesting stories. A platform for the kingdom to derive the glory. Worldwide and we live on the huge stream. What you know about the Gospel Rhythms Magazine? But God's in it. You don't got to chase dreams. You need to check us out and see what cast we mean. Cast a vision. Cast a vision.
Okay. We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Marsha Witeka, inviting you to join me every Monday at 1 p.m. for Born to Talk, where conversation plus connections equal community. Be sure to tune in to Born to Talk with Marsha Witeka, Mondays at 1 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also listen live at iTunes Radio R&B, TuneIn Radio, Radio Flag, Live 365, or AHA Radio. This is reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. We are LA Talk Live, and we are born to talk.
This is Stephen Van Heflin, director of DatStone High Tech Learning Academy, inviting you to join us every Monday, 3 p.m. Pacific, for the We Are Code VR Tech Show. The We Are Code VR Tech Show is dedicated to growing a community of VR, virtual reality, and AR, augmented reality, developers in urban communities creating social solutions using virtual reality and educational engagement in mobile apps, website design, VR development, drone building and programming, robotics, 3D gaming, gaming, and we invite you to change the tech industry so there is more racial and gender diversity and inclusion. We also believe the We Are Code VR Tech Show on LA Talk Live can create creators and not just consumers of technology. So don't forget to tune in to the We Are Code VR Tech Show every Monday, 3 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, and now on Facebook Live. Watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasures. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
All right, all right. We are back.
Gospel Rhythms
in the house, everybody.
Yes, we are. And you know what? Our guest is really on the way. My dyslexic butt twisted up the address. So it's totally on me. I am so sorry. You know.
Stuff happens. You're human.
Man.
It's okay.
It kind of sucks.
See, isn't it interesting how I said something crazy last week and you sent the man the wrong address to come to the studio this week?
Well, I emailed the correct one, but I text in the effort to, like, you know, them not have to look it up. But bad row, bad row.
Bad row. It's okay. I forgive you.
I don't forgive me. I don't like wasting people's time or gas.
It's okay. You know what? We're not going to waste the time. We're going to actually talk about him so that you know who he is before he comes into the studio.
Yes.
He's an awesome guy. I've actually watched some videos on him. But his name is Herb Trawick, executive producer, co-host of Pensado's Place. And Herb is the creator, executive producer, and co-host of hot internet show Pensado's Place, seen in over 204 countries by 10 million people a year. Wow. Pensado's Place is the leading digital media show in the audio space.
Wow, it is. Creativity combined with taste and relentless execution is his mantra. From manager to label exec, Broadway producer to author, executive producer to talent scout, co-host to advisor, Trawick remains true to his vision with real results. As manager and executive producer, Herb built, and I was there. I was at Mercury Records for this, so I had
when
a front
Brian
row
McKnight
seat.
Came out?
I had a front row seat. I was at Mercury Records. Brian McKnight.
Wow.
Yep, he built Brian McKnight into an R&B star. Ed Eckstein was the label head, and he had just signed him on.
Nice.
Yep. With 20 million albums sold, gold tours, and 30-plus Grammys, American Music, Billboard, Emmys, and Image Award nominations. Woo!
Wow.
Yeah, I was there, front row seat.
Oh, man, I've got a story to tell you about that, too. Brian really? McKnight. Oh, yeah. I've got it. Yeah. So, anyway, client Dave Pensado is a mixing legend who has hits with Beyonce, Michael Jackson, Shakira, Wiz Khalifa, Christina Aguilera, Afrojack, and Jill Scott, among others. Herb was a partner of the legendary creator of Earth, Wind, and Fire, Maurice White. He took the EWF catalog to Broadway and was a producer of the play
Hot Feet.
Like that.
He is a multiple winner of the Manager of the Year Award from BRE Magazine, from marketing chief at Solar Records to running imprints at Interscope, nice. RCA, Mercury, and Capitol, along with consultancies.
I'm sorry, I wasn't reading
at
along.
Motown, Def yes, Jam, and I got it already. And Primary Wave Publishing. Herb has been asked to lend his expertise his entire career. When asked why such a diverse career, Trawick replies, why not? It's a privilege and a blast.
And as my sister has shown you, reading is fundamental. Amen.
Oh, no, you don't have jokes. I know you don't have jokes, okay? And you back there laughing. You know what? First of
Richard
all,
is my
not having
today.
Your glasses is fundamental, because if I had my glasses, I could see. Do you see how tiny this print
too.
Is? Okay.
Whatever.
Do you see how tiny this print is?
I wear glasses.
It was a blur.
Are you nearsighted, like, far sighted?
It don't matter.
Exactly.
I was blurred sighted. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I got
you. You could just try to throw me under the bus.
Okay, I threw you under the bus.
But you advertised it for the world to see.
Oh,
but that's
come
okay.
On. Can we all just get along?
Oh, no.
Oh, you
no,
gotta
no,
do
no,
unto
okay.
others as you would have
it's
them
okay.
do unto you.
You remember that.
Come on.
The next time I'm rolling over your
as you love yourself.
When I'm rolling over you in reverse. And
these public threats made worldwide?
You heard it here.
If something happens to me, you all know.
Oh,
this
please.
One right here is responsible. Okay,
not literally.
If I come up missing,
not
Lord,
literally.
I rebuke that in the name of Jesus. If I come up missing, this one right here, that's where you go. That's
if she
who
come
you look
up
for.
Missing, you better believe she's got an all-you-can-eat buffet, and she ain't coming out till the next day.
And
all right, I'm just gonna let you. That's where she gonna be. Where is she? Well, she's probably eating home buffet out of their buffet.
Let me tell you what I'm thankful for. Amen. I'm thankful for food. Food is a beautiful thing. I thank God for food every day.
She don't even gain an inch.
I thank God for that, too. I don't gain an inch.
That's a shame.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord,
hopefully
have
that
mercy.
Lasts a good another 10 years. Hopefully I got 10 more years and not gaining another inch like that.
Lord, have mercy.
All right. So Herb's on the way. And
I know Miss Mantalk got something to talk about.
Yes, Miss Mantalk
I
does.
May not.
I went to D.C.
Well, you had something about Brian McKnight. You was going to share with us.
I wanted to share with her
you
when
stay
he got
on,
here.
Your thoughts are all over the place.
Well, you just,
is this something you want to share with us?
Get you some this is what happens when we allow our emotions and our anger to influence us.
I was waiting at the bit, chomping at the bit to find out the Brian McKnight
we
story.
We start to. Do things like this. All right. So, okay. So here's the Brian McKnight story. So I had a record out.
You did?
The same time that Brian had a record out. We both came out at the same time. We were in.
Is this a true story?
No. Or was you dreaming? I'm going to say on gospel rhythms and lie to everybody.
You could be dreaming.
I'm just going to be a lying Christian today.
I learned something today. You had a record out. Lord, what was the call?
Is this what I have to do?
I didn't know that. Okay. Something today.
Let me call Jesus because I can't take this.
Jesus on the main line. Come on.
Lord, could you help me right now?
What's the record?
This one?
What's the record?
All right. So, okay. So I had a record out. Lord, was this back in 1992, I believe? And so I think that's around the time that Brian McKnight came out. You remember that year? Was that a good year?
I don't remember
for you?
The year, but.
Okay, of course
okay.
not. So anyway, we were both in the CD disc makers. Do you remember they used to have the. I don't know if they still do because I'm just clueless.
Before
that.
My time, but
the
exactly
CD
what is that?
Before your time. But yet you were right there in the front row seat when all this happened, and that was before your time. Okay. So
I was
anyway.
A baby. Did I mention I was in a carriage?
The CD disc makers. You still are. The CD disc makers. And so, yeah, he had a wonderful write-up. I had a wonderful write-up. So what had happened was.
I'm a Google this.
I ended up getting together with my son's father and following him and his dream to open up a restaurant, a dance club. In Champaign, Illinois, and so the record company let me go. And they told me, if you leave, this is what Fred Robinson said to me, he's the president of Star City Records. He said, if you leave, you
are going to get dropped.
He said, these were his exact words, quote unquote, I will drop you like a hot potato. And when I tell you that man meant every bit of what he said.
You couldn't even call him. The number you have reached.
Exactly. Like, I have not spoken or seen him. Spoken
he
to
not
or
even
seen
on Facebook.
Him since. He's like a ghost right now. So, Fred Robinson, if you're out there, I love you. I'm sorry. I messed up.
Wait,
I mean,
what
I
was
love
the song?
I'm thankful for my son, though. I'm thankful for my son, but it was a rough ride.
What was the song?
Ain't No Love Like Mine.
Was that original?
I forgot the guys that wrote it, but these guys wrote and produced it. We had this bad saxophone player. Girl, to me, the saxophone player was the best thing on that record.
And you were a solo artist?
I was Trisha Mann. And I had a little black dress. And I was trying to pose all sexy. I didn't know nothing about sexy back then. I was like, what, 21, 22?
You didn't know anything about sexy. This girl was born sexy. Probably in a sexy
okay,
pose.
Come on, with gospel rhythms. You're not going to talk about sex.
Now, why not?
I was sexy. Like
you know, Christians can be sexy.
Like
that's the problem.
And yeah, it was, yeah. I think, yeah. I got the CD at home. Yes, we can be sexy. Yes, we can.
Yeah, well, so, you know, I have a record label story for myself.
Uh-oh, talk to
I
me.
I was a part of a group, too.
Cuckoo and...
No, actually, the group was called She, okay? And we did have a record on the radio. Well, I got kicked out the group.
The She's?
It was called She, like Guy She.
And why
and
did
it was
you
called,
get kicked out the group, Ro?
Why?
Because
I
was... Because you was cutting up.
Hey, no. What had happened was the song was called Hello Stranger. And let's just say Dr. York, who was like the Berry Gordy at the time of the group. And we had to deal with Warlock Records And yeah. I knew right then and there something was wrong. My mom would not approve of me being on Warlock Records.
Yeah, there was something not quite right about that.
Just
that
the name. Like, why would you call your label Warlock? And don't that mean like a male witch or something?
But you remember the group, Bone Thugs and Harmony, Poe Broke and Lonely. I used to hang out with them back in the day. There was a group called Poe Broke and Lonely, and they were great. I love those guys.
Why would you name yourself that,
but
though?
That's what I asked one of them. I said, why did you guys name yourselves Poe Broke
and
Lonely?
What you call
Lonely? And...
They yeah. Poe and they broke and they
lonely.
I'm not
gonna say that. No, I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna say
we
that.
We gonna Google
I'm just
them.
Saying.
But so
I'm just saying. .. But
yeah. But I
they
ended
were
up,
cool. I liked those guys.
Well, you know? I ended up being ejected from the group. because let's just say we didn't have a meeting of the minds. The manager / producer or person that we had to report to, and sometimes you have to not compromise your values and stand up for what you know is right, because sometimes this industry, it can make you ask for your soul, ask for you to sell yourself, and I was not willing to do that, so I got the boot, and I was okay with that. But I'll never forget, I was at Heavy D and the boys. They had like a party and it was an auction. And I'll never forget. The girls' record was on. It was three girls. Their record was on the radio. It was called Hello Stranger. It was a remake. Mm-hmm. And I remember seeing them get out of the Rolls Royce and come in. And they were like, you know, the stars. And, you know, I had a moment for a minute there. And then I just was like, well, God had something else for me.
See, yeah, there you go. Exactly.
But I
he
also
had gospel rhythms.
Oh, yeah. But I'm saying fast forward a couple years later, I saw how it all went down. And I really had a front row seat to be like, yes, you really did. I mean, I can't go into details on air. But yeah, it was definitely a moment where I look back and I was like, wow, I didn't know then, but now I know. And sometimes God, you don't always know why you do what you do, but... Or why God does what he does, rather, and doesn't allow some opportunities when you're so close and you feel like you got it. Like, have you ever been like the next to the last person who right before a big part, you'll get it. And it's between you and one other actress. And
oh, my
it's
God.
Like,
how many times? How many directors have said, oh, my God, Trisha, I love you. You're so awesome. You're such a great actress. But we got to get this person who's on the TV show right now, and I'm thinking, okay, somebody gave them a shot, and somebody gave her a shot, somebody gave her a shot, and I love all those
but
ladies.
But you got a name!
But, you know, the people that have had television shows or have been in lots of major films or things like that, they're more recognizable faces and names. And I understand from a producer's point, that's what you want, but it gets annoying when people are like, oh, you're so great, I just love you, but I don't want to hear that anymore.
Right.
You know, you should pursue your acting, because you guys, she's really good. She's actually an amazing actress. I saw a clip on her. I think I said that before.
You know,
but you should really think about pursuing it. But let me tell you about the music.
One thing
business.
You got to do is read. And according to
it's
my team up in here, it's fundamental. Yes, let me get a hold of the fundamentals.
Right. But you know, back in the day, and I don't know how they do it now, because things are so different with all the things are just different in the music industry now. But back then in the 90s, you know, the record company will hook you up. They'd give you all this money in advance, and they'd give you the car, and you got all these hotel rooms. And guess what? All of that is coming out of your check.
I saw Beyonce so cold with it, because she cut all of them out. She's like, look, I'm not even going to go do any pre-advertising, any marketing. I'm just going to make everybody sign confidentiality contracts, put my stuff together, package it together with my resources, my money, my people, and keep every cent to myself, because I'm going to release it on my terms.
Oh, yeah, because the record companies, they're wonderful, but they can get you. And you look up, you're getting 10 cents off of, if that, sometimes 7-5 cents off. Some people, 3 off of their own album, and the record company and everybody else is getting the majority and the bulk of the money, and you're out there doing all that work.
Well,
so that was back in the day. I don't know how it is now. I really don't.
Yeah, it's definitely a different beast now. But in the spirit of being thankful, from all the closed doors, you know, I posted something saying, you know what, God, I thank you for my losses. I thank you for the adversity and the challenges. You know, so often we're like, I thank you for my clothes. I thank you for my car. And you don't really give credence to those missteps and those adversities, those challenges, those heartaches, and those places that your life journey has taken, that in that moment you wouldn't have thanked God for all the whatever in you. But when you look back, it's like, whew, you know what? God, even that is purposeful. Even the manure of this event or that event or the other event has been purposeful in helping shape who I am today.
Yeah, the mistakes help you grow. Well, at least they're supposed to. Hopefully you do grow and don't keep making the same mistakes, because then that is what they deem insanity, is when you keep doing the same thing over and over and over and over. So yeah, I've learned. I look back. Some of the crazy stuff I have done in the past. And I'm like, wow.
I can't wait for the book. When the book coming out?
When the book is coming out? I am. You guys, I do have a book coming out very soon. If I could stop collecting testimonies from people. Yeah. And if you do have a testimony for me, I don't know. Should I give out the email?
I mean, you know, they can look you up or they may want to have you on their show to talk about what you're working on.
Right, because I'm going to be collecting testimonies, because I plan to do a volume 2, volume 3, 4, different things talking about all kinds of stuff and getting all these testimonies from people. So, yeah, I'll keep you guys posted real soon. As soon as I solidify some things, you know.
What you solidify?
I am solidifying things.
So when are you wrapping this up?
Wrapping the book
up? Is it going to be out next year?
Yes. Yes, it is. I speak that. I don't spoke that.
I don't know. Well, how? Thank you for tuning in. Stay tuned. We're going to go to a commercial.
And take another commercial break.
Yes, we are. Pay some bills.
A G to the O-S-P-E-L. Gospel rhythms in the house. And you know
it. Hey, keep it right here. We'll be back.
Yeah.
Gay. Can't you see what's going on? Through it all, gospel rhythm still going strong. Trust in God when it's good or when it's going wrong. Encourage other believers to keep holding on. Catch the vision and we making it plain. We the head, not the tail, so we won't complain. Here to lift up the downcast and the broken hearted. Changing lives with the truth, so let's get it started. We got the word, music, entertainment, light. You can catch us on the air every Sunday night. With special guests, the news, and interesting stories. A platform for the kingdom to derive the glory.
We know there are many choices out there. Radio and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Marsha Witeka inviting you to join me every Monday at 1 p.m. for Born to Talk, where conversation plus connections equal community. Be sure to tune in to Born to Talk with Marsha Witeka, Mondays at 1 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also listen live at iTunes Radio R&B, TuneIn Radio, Radio Flag, Live 365, or AHA Radio. This is reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. We are LA Talk Live, and we are born to talk.
Hi, I'm Del A.D. Jones, and I'm a certified relationship and divorce coach.
And I'm Debbie Carlin Boyle, a certified personal trainer, fitness instructor, and health coach.
Join us on Tuesdays, 2 p.m. Pacific, for Del and Debbie's Mind, Body, Soul, and everything in between, exclusively on LA Talk Live.
Become part of the conversation with expert guests discussing life-changing topics such as relationships, divorce, longevity, parenting challenges, dating, intimacy, and so much more.
We would love to hear your opinions and questions either on our Facebook page or by calling us directly at 323-473-3100. We are Del and Debbie's Mind, Body, Soul, and everything in between. Tuesdays, 2 p.m. Pacific on LATalkLive.com.
You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B and now live on Facebook, or watch and listen directly at LATalkLive.com. And now on our YouTube channel, Del and Debbie Mind, Body, Soul. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
What up, LA? It's Mr. Vaughn inviting you to join me every Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific, for Los Angeles Today. Purple nights and golden days. I'm so LA. Coming live and direct on LA Talk Live.
Entertainment, current events, special guests, sports, the hottest and latest in LA.
Where the twist goes down daily. Boss up with us every Friday, 3 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes, R&B, or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasures. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, H-Town, what it do? It's your girl, Jackie Elam, author, speaker, entrepreneur, and Hollywood set mom. Tune into America Talk Live on latalklive.com every Saturday at 12 noon Pacific to check out my new show, Jackie Elam Live. I will reveal the world of child performers and various forms of entertainment for all ages. My guests and I are going to empower and educate you with helpful stories, topics, and advice about the show business. This is going to be a fun-filled hour, so don't forget to tune in to Jackie Elam Live every Saturday, 12 noon Pacific, on latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, shout out to What's the Count? I'm Ferran Dozier.
And I'm your boy, Cali Sportsman, inviting you to join us
every Saturday at 2 p.m. Pacific on the Sports Lounge Live.
Explore the world of sports, from amateur to the pros, the community on a global level, relevant sports news, and guess what? We even have live studio guests.
So don't forget to tune into the Sports Lounge Live every Saturday, 2 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on latalklive.com and the America Talk Live Broadcast Network.
Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live.
And we are more than just talk. Hey, hey, shout us out, What's the Count? I'm your host, I am WDC. Tune in to WDC Radio on LA Talk Live every Saturday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 7 p.m. Eastern Time, for sickle cell trait awareness, lupus, bullying, mental health, and all different aspects of life. So tune in to WDC Radio right here on LA Talk Live. Also, you can listen to us on iTunes, Live 365, YouTube, and Ustream. And don't forget Apple TV and Roku right here on LA Talk Live, where we're more than just talk. Shout us out. What's the count?
Hello, I'm Joel Ramirez.
And I'm Lolita Robinson Coppedge, and welcome to Joy in My House
on LATalkLive.com. Inspirational radio
with a touch of recovery.
A reality show where nothing is left unsaid
and no one is insignificant who says it.
Exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hey, this is Trisha Mann Grant, and I am inviting you to join us every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth. And join us as we talk to the Christians, just not any Christian, but all Christians of entertainment and all walks of life. Don't forget to tune in to Gospel Rhythms, Heaven's Party here on Earth every Sunday, 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, exclusively on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, TuneIn Radio, AHA Radio, TiVo Radio, and Apple TV Radio. Or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
This is Stephen Van Heflin, director of Dat Stone High Tech Learning Academy, inviting you to join us every Monday, 3 p.m. Pacific, for the We Are Code VR Tech Show. The We Are Code VR Tech Show is dedicated to growing a community of VR, virtual reality, and AR, augmented reality, developers in urban communities creating social solutions using virtual reality and educational engagement in mobile apps, website design, VR development, drone building and programming, robotics, 3D gaming, Academy, and we invite you to change the tech industry so there is more racial and gender diversity and inclusion. We also believe the We Are Code VR Tech Show on LA Talk Live can create creators and not just consumers of technology. So don't forget to tune in to the We Are Code VR Tech Show every Monday, 3 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, and now on Facebook Live. Watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasures. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, I'm Del A.D. Jones, and I'm a certified relationship and divorce coach.
And I'm Debbie Carlin Boyle, a certified personal trainer, fitness instructor, and health coach.
Join us on Tuesdays, 2 p.m. Pacific, for Del and Debbie's Mind, Body, Soul, and Everything in Between, exclusively on LA Talk Live.
Become part of the conversation with expert guests discussing life-changing topics such as relationships, divorce, longevity, parenting challenges, dating, intimacy, and so much more.
We would love to hear your opinions and questions, either on our Facebook page or by calling us directly at 323-473-3100. We are Del and Debbie's Mind, Body, Soul, and Everything in Between. Tuesdays, 2 p.m. Pacific on latalklive.com.
You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B, and now live on Facebook. Or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. And now on our YouTube channel, Del and Debbie Mind, Body, Soul. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Starla Quarles, and I'm inviting you to join us every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. for The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People. Join us as we discuss the topics that are relevant to today's generational leaders. So don't forget to tune in to The Dialogue, Real Talk, Real People, every Wednesday from 5 to 6 p.m. right here on latalklive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B, Live 365, Radio Flag, and now Stitcher Radio. Or watch and listen directly at latalklive.com. Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
It's Jackie Elam here, author, speaker, entrepreneur, and Hollywood stepmom. Tune in to America Talk Live on latalklive.com every Saturday, 12 noon Pacific, to check out my new show, Jackie Elam Live. I will reveal the world of child performers and various forms of entertainment for all ages. My guests and I will empower and educate you with a couple stories and advice about the show business. Please be sure to tune in to Jackie Elam Live every Saturday, 12 noon Pacific, on latalklive.com. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live. And we are more than just talk.
Right.
Mic check. 1 2 1 2. Mic check. 1 2 1 2.
All right, guys, we're back.
Are we on air?
Cause okay.
Yeah.
We have no. Yeah.
It's okay. There we go.
Yeah.
There
it is. We hear the party now.
Cause we got the best engineer in the house. He done worked it out.
Lord, we just thank you for this day, even with the challenges. You know, our guest is still in it, trying to get here. It's bananas out there, traffic wise, and. You know, of course, my initial mix up, and it's just like, Lord, have your way.
That's
you know,
okay.
I know, but I mean, I've been so excited about him coming into, you know, the studio and just seeing what we do and being a part of it and hearing his story. And I'm just,
and he's
my
still
heart
coming.
Is aching right now. Who he's trying. You may have to turn around if it doesn't make sense. He's an awesome man, and he so full of talent, and just to see like all the different things that he has done and the path that he's taken, especially with the whole internet movement, very inspiring. And I definitely, at the Living Legends Award, got an opportunity to learn a little bit more about him and his story. And I was like, man, it would be great to have him come in. And for me to have accidentally sent the, you know, flip the numbers around, like I just,
trying to hold back tears right now because I don't like wasting people's time, you know, and I do take what we do here seriously. And thank you, Richard. Thank you, Milo. Milo knows she's in studio. She's been holed up.
I tried to get her. I told her, look, we can interview you until you get. She's like, oh, no. She said, I'm behind the scenes, honey. I'm behind the scenes. So.
You could be in a chair like Charlie.
Right. Turn your back. You could do that, Milo. Walk backwards this way. And
she's
it will
not
just
even
trying. Right.
She's not even feeling it. Just hold she's the
like,
mic.
You should see the look I'm getting right now.
It's like, girl, that's stay in your lane. Stay in your lane.
I'll just leave that alone. All right, Milo. She's a sweetheart.
Oh, no, that's not from him.
But you saw something at the Legends Award. What was it that you could share? He can elaborate on it when he gets here.
Well,
and let me just say to our viewers out there, we will be able to go over a little bit of our normal time so that we can talk to him and have a really, you know, decent interview with him. But go ahead. What were you saying?
I mean, when you think of somebody's life, body of life work, it's a lot, you know. I knew him as a manager, and then seeing him have success in the field that we're in, you know, he shared at the awards, like, people thought he was crazy when he calls it internet television. He was like, yeah, they thought I was crazy, you know, until checks start rolling in, you know, and just not being pigeonholed to one lane and being able to diversify your portfolio of gifts. I think that's the biggest thing. It's like what makes a lot of artists successful across the board today. It's just like with Beyonce, learning how to diversify your portfolio of gifts. I'm not just a singer. I may not be a musician in terms of being able to play 100 million instruments, but I can write. You know, I'm really dedicated at my craft as an artist. You know, I'll explore other lanes, whether it's being fashion or whether it be in the sphere of acting. It's like, you know, you are not just an actress, you know, you have producing and created a show called Man Talk. You have your books that you're working on. You're a poet. You have the Poetrish series situation going on. So it's like, you know, it's great when you can tap into people that have or have arrived at a place where you're kind of striving to be, to say, wow, how can I, you know, do that? You know, because even with Gospel Rhythms, we got Gospel Rhythms Live, we have the magazine at Dream aspect of it, we got the website. It's like, you know, with Herb Trawick and his partner, Dave Pensado, who was one of his clients, they have Pensado's Place, and there they have the Pensado Awards. They had the third one this year, and then they have the episodes of this of the Pensado's Place series that they have, and they cater to their market and to their genre of influence, which is music, engineering, and mixing, and producing, and writing, and all those things and elements that are there, and it works. And so, you know, he didn't allow the fact that he was an executive at a label or that he was a manager. You know, that was his gift that he managed, whether it be Brian McKnight, Vanessa Williams, or whoever all the artists were that were in his management portfolio, pigeonhole him into just doing that. He took risks. He that's why he got a Creative Visionary Award at the Living Legends Foundation, is because you want to think outside the box, you know. And,
I was just
and,
about to say yeah, that.
And this yeah. color box, because, you know, it's like, you know, perhaps a large portion, and we get an opportunity to talk to him, of the people that he works around may not be his color, you know. So you sometimes it's a stepping outside of your comfort zone of people that you are used to working around with. So
he came up. Did he come up with the idea? Who came up with the idea for internet TV?
We'll have to talk to him in the very beginning process
from what you can remember.
No,
right?
You have to ask him that. I hope we get the chance to ask him that, because I don't want to misquote.
Okay.
So we're just waiting, drum roll, we're waiting and praying in the meantime.
That's good.
I've been trying to get him in here since forever.
I know.
Dad row.
No, it's okay. Stuff happens, you guys. Don't beat yourself up, girl.
Yeah, but
come
you know
on,
what?
Don't beat yourself up.
I guess, in this thing, it's like, God, there's a reason for everything you let it allow in your life, but why? Some things don't make sense. So how do you have to, you just have to just let the peace of God that transcends all understanding just guard your heart and mind and do like an All About the Benjamins. That ain't biblical, but L-I-G. And I just, you know, I just let it go.
Quoting the movies.
Quoting the movies now.
Lean not
because
to
you know why?
Understanding.
If you fixate and focus on the disappointment, because I'm greatly disappointed, and you know I don't like I said, you don't. I don't ever want to waste anybody's time, you know, or any of that. So how do you make it right?
You just make it right by playing a song that like Tony this. Grant is Yay. Singing on.
Uh-oh, what
Yay,
song is
Richard.
This? You're going to break the mood. What's the name of it? What is it?
I see headlights. Well, I'm trying to figure it out. I
see the headlights.
You see the headlights?
Cause I'm telling him. Your wife
storm.
Don't know your song.
Oh, this is Storm with him and Vince, right, Storm? Oh, Brighter Day. Like I said, this is Brighter Day.
Look. You know
hey,
what?
Look, I was close.
Wait.
Storm and a Brighter Day is all the same theme. You know what I'm saying? Same, baby.
Tony, your
he's
wife
on stage
does
right
not
now.
Know your
you
song.
You better not text him. Yeah, he's on stage with Love Jones right now. But this is for you, Ro. Richard, put this up for you to encourage you, sis.
Yeah, thank you.
Come on, listen.
It's a Brighter Day. It's a Brighter Day. It's a Brighter Day. It's a Brighter Day.
Choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
What's not to love when I wake up in the morning, love? I thank my God above for you. What's not to love? There ain't nothing I won't do to make sure that I can spend my life with you. I love everything about you, girl.
What's not to love?
Turn yourself around so I can see the love that I found and all the special things about you. And girl, the way you fit that dress, you're giving me ideas like pillow talk.
Yeah.
Rub you down, yeah. Drinks on the rocks. Well, it's a private party, and I know I'm a lucky man. Cause on a scale of 1 to 10, I'll see it again.
What's not to love? When I wake up in the morning, love, I thank my God above for you.
I'm so thankful, yeah.
What's not to love?
And there ain't nothing I won't do to make sure that I can spend my life with you.
Baby, let me count the ways.
What's not to love?
I love the way you walk.
Two.
The way you laugh, the way you talk.
Three.
Sexy clothes you wear.
Four.
Oh, when you dance, hold it right.
Five.
Baby girl, you're the best.
Six.
Even when your hair's a mess.
Seven.
The way you love.
Eight.
The way you kiss.
Nine.
Everything about
what's not to love? When I wake up in the morning, love, I thank my God above.
For you.
What's not to love? There ain't nothing I won't do to make sure that I can spend my life with
be
you.
With you.
I love everything about you, girl.
What's not to love?
What's not to love?
What's not to love?
What's not to love?
What's not,
what's
to,
not
love?
To love?
just hope that tomorrow is better than yesterday. I pray about tomorrow like I prayed about today. And I pray that tomorrow is gonna be better than yesterday. Of today, they're the next generation. It's gotta be better than yesterday. The world I see tomorrow is not the world I see today. For the world I see tomorrow is to be better than yesterday. Yesterday.
The sounds of my husband, Mr. Tony Grant, who's out on tour right now with Love Jones the Musical, and that is his hit Yesterday. Yes, awesome. And you guys,
welcome back
to Gospel Rhythms. I'm Trisha Mann Grant.
I'm Ro Williams.
And we have Mr.
Herb
Trawick in the house. Yes.
That's the most applause I've ever had in my life. By the way, I worked with your husband for a long
time.
Did
you?
As Tony.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Where'd you guys? I knew Tony pre-you.
Oh, wow.
I managed Tony through that.
So, as yet, were you with him in his as yet days?
We have a lot to discuss.
it's a small world.
It's such a small world.
Tell him Herb said hello.
Oh, my gosh. Are you kidding me?
That just means I'm old. Will. That's
yeah,
all.
Yeah, no, that doesn't mean that. It means you're well-seasoned.
Still cute, but
you
old.
Yes.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Well-seasoned. We're so glad you made it.
Yay, thank you for persevering.
I'm glad to be here.
It is so my fault.
This is where fine helps. See, when you're as good-looking as the co-host, which you guys can't see, they could send you anywhere. So I was in Thanksgiving traffic. I pulled up in Santa Monica at 1900 Sepulveda, and the folks there said, "Excuse me, sir, what are you looking for?" And I said, "Oh, I'm in the wrong place." We're good. Yeah. Happy to be here.
Yeah.
Good to be here and proud to support.
We sent you across the country.
I sure did. She was almost in tears. I was brokenhearted.
No, don't. Yeah, be joyful. Really,
Thank you.
So, before you got here, we told everyone all about you. But to hear the things come out of your mouth is going to be a whole nother show. But we have already given you a whole bio, talked about you. She was really
raving.
Just amazing, raving about you from the Legends Award and you starting, well, not starting, I need to know, you when you told people about internet TV, they thought you were nuts.
Absolutely.
Tell me all about that.
I think that when you're in entertainment, depending on what you do in it, is something that is cyclical and it goes up and down in terms of its vertical and its verticality and horizontal. So seasons come around and that sometimes you're in season, sometimes you're not. And then your career goes up and down.
Sure.
And I tell people that generally if you get from 18, 19 to about 30, that's phase one. Generally, people are phased out. The biggest ism in entertainment is ageism, not sexism, not racism, although all those isms are there. But if you make it through 30 to 40, you can go from 40 to 70. So you'll see people like Clive Davis and Berry Gordy and all those folks. They last forever. I had had a pretty good run, but was just sort of out of gas. I didn't want to go back and manage, and I managed some recording engineers way in the beginning of my career, and a good friend of mine who's a recording engineer, who's now my partner, had a stroke. And I had an idea. And the idea was how to take his brand and put it on the internet and do something with it. But I was just sharing as a friend. I mean, part of the blessings of my career is I tend to have a fair amount of people who will contact me for advice, which is an honor to me because people have to decide that you have something worthy to say to them for them to ask you, right? Mm-hmm. And then I think you also have to have a willing spirit to share it, right? And people pick that up over time. And this idea, a digital network in Santa Monica heard about it, and we had gone down there for some purpose. It was very complicated at the time because it was my partner was going to have to invest money. Y'all know that this isn't cheap. Like, it costs, and it costs to build it and so on and so forth. And but I was just trying to help him out. This digital network heard about it and pitched me on doing it as a show. My partner could not be the farthest thing from a broadcaster in the history of broadcasting. Literally, when they put who should not be a broadcaster in the dictionary, it has his face, but it has it four or five times.
Oh,
it doesn't
no.
just have it once, right? It's on steroids. And I also was thinking about how to take people who ordinarily had been in the shadows and try to expose them. So that means that they're not comfortable being on microphones or in front of cameras and all that kind of stuff. But my boy needed to figure out how to have his career go. He was 11 days from death. They're about to pull the plug on him. He's had a miraculous recovery, and now through our auspices is the largest online teacher in audio in the world. But I'll get to that in a second.
Wow.
So when this idea... Ooh, thank you very much.
Awesome.
Thank you. Thank you. So basically, if you want the chronology, I'll try to do the short version of the chronology. We were down at this digital network. A guy had sold his business to AOL for about $25 million, and he had started a digital network called This Week In. It would be This Week in American Idol, This Week in Comedy, This Week in NFL, This Week in Cars. It was all kinds of different programming. And we went down there just to see a friend of ours, and they had a bunch of digital geeks around, so I started asking the geeks about the idea. What do you think about this? If I took a platinum engineer and figured out some cool stuff on the internet and put it, and they said, oh, we think, and before I knew it, I had like 8 or 9 people around us. That then turned into me getting an email the next day from the CEO saying we want to do this as a show.
Wow.
So I went to my partner and I said, you have an opportunity. Now, mind you, this had nothing to do with me. I'm just being a messenger. Like, I had no idea about being involved in it, not being on the air. It wasn't a show for us. It was an idea for him. I was Maurice White's partner at the time. I was plenty busy doing my thing. He looked at me and said, I don't know how to do this. How are we going to do this? And I was like, well, you have to figure it out because you have some savings and you have to. His basic problem financially was he had been a big mix engineer, Justin Timberlake and, you know, Shakira and Kelly Clarkson and all these different people, Michael Jackson. And how was he going to take being in a commercial studio and now, because he's recovering from a stroke, work at home and then also capture this content to put on the web, which he had nothing to do about. So this show idea was a way for him to capture the content or capture it without having to pay. Mm-hmm. So I was like, you got to do this. Now you got to figure out what to do with it. So, again, because I'm that kind of friend, so I started writing little scripts and going out to his house and testing. I was putting X's on the walls. He's ringing to them. And again, I can't tell you the definition of awful. It was just, I mean, his pets had their paws over their eyes. No. Like, it just was. And it was because he'd never done it before. Mm-hmm. So we're rehearsing, and I'm coming up with all these kind of segment ideas, and I had a sort of vision for it. And I finally said, you need a co-host. And he agreed. And so we're looking for a co-host. And his wife calls and says, I found a co-host. And I was like, who is it? I didn't realize you were looking, but that's another story. And she said, it's you. Right. And I said, there's no way under God's green earth, I'm not doing this.
Why? Why did you say no?
Well, here's why. At the time, in my view, see, the music business and the audio business are two different things. Mm. So record people hire audio people to do a mix or to do a live show, and then they go back into the business of making records, selling records, getting them to people. They're not the same business. So I'm from the record business. I was a manager in the record business. Had a pretty good run as a manager in the record business. All of a sudden, I'm going to go in the audio space, of which I know nothing about. That made no sense to me. So I was trying to find this better audio-based person. But then Jesus intervened, as Jesus always does. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. He had a different plan. And the pilots were within like 4 days. So I just agreed to do the pilots with him because I'd been rehearsing with him. He's like, okay, God, thank God. So we go do the pilots. I don't want to do it. I don't want to be on the internet. I don't want to be flamed. I don't want to do any of this. And the CEO, we do the pilots, and I got an email from the CEO the next day. He said, I got good news and bad news. The good news is we can tell you've rehearsed. The bad news is he's terrible, and we won't go forward unless you do it with him.
Oh.
So now I got a dilemma. My boys had a stroke.
Yeah.
They want to go forward. I don't want to test his cash. You know, mm-hmm. I'm partners with Maurice White. What? Mm-hmm. You know what? Mm-hmm. So I agreed to do it. And they had a setup somewhat similar, very television based. And they had a little sales team, and we went to Santa Monica. So for about 6 months, we would meet at El Pollo Loco, out on Sepulveda in Sherman Oaks. Maurice White's office was there. I'd pick him up. We'd drive and do the show, and I'd come back, and I'd go back upstairs, and we'd talk on the way back. In about the second month, we knew that his wife was actually watching the comments. I wasn't. Mm-hmm. And about the second month, we had like 5 schools. And by the third month, we had like 9. Mm. And I remember we had what we call a sushi conversation. I took him to sushi, and I said, look, man.
That's a favorite conversation, right? You just spoke her language.
Oh, we can go to Kabuki.
I got a couple places for you. Katsuya. Yeah, Katsuya, yeah. Sugarfish. There's a little place by Santa Monica Airport, little secret spot. Nice. I got secret spots, public spots, all that.
All right.
Anyways, I hope this isn't boring. By the way.
No.
So long story short, we started measuring the schools. In the sushi conversation, I said, okay, something's happening here. I can stop looking for a co-host and commit. And we've been friends for 25 years, by the way. I was his first manager. Mm-hmm. And I said, but Dave, you know me. Now, if we're going to do this, I'm going to do this. Like, I have no interest in sort of doing it. It's just not been my thing. And it wasn't ego. It's just that I'm going to be judged differently than you are. He would be popular amongst audio engineers and do a service. I'm going to be judged as a businessman. And a businessman and somebody who has vision. Can I turn it into something? And he said, let's go. And so that's another part of the Jesus part of this, where Jesus put the right people together who can understand each other and trust each other. And so he gives me an enormous amount of latitude. Mm-hmm. We co-own the show. And that started in 2011. And as of this airing, this discussion, it's in 203 countries. 600,000 people a month watch it. We have about 6 verticals. We have e-commerce. We have a curriculum series where we sign authors to do audiobooks that are distributed in 65 countries and 7,000 web outlets. We have live events all over the world. We have the largest audio award show in the history of audio, which I don't say our competitor, let me be fair to them. There was somebody else who honored the people we honored, and they've been doing it for 31 years. Mm-hmm. And we beat them in the third year. So we now have a lot. So we've been covered by a lot of people. We've been covered by Forbes magazine three times. We've been covered by Huffington Post. We've been covered by. So, you know, if what is the lesson to all this? Dream.
Hmm. Wow.
Go hard. Get out if you're not going to go hard. Don't not show your best. That is your obligation, period. Mark Cuban always says, the one thing you can control is your effort.
Right.
If you can't, so I'm just somebody who likes to grind. I'm not trying to pat myself on the back. I'm not trying to do any of that. But we built something to the premise of your question that for 3 years, I couldn't even tell my friends. They would have just said, oh, Herb, oh, that's so sweet. You're going to build a show on audio engineers on the internet. Like, but behind my back, Herb has gone crazy. He has lost his mind and need to commit him. So literally, we had a book. And once the book came out and Forbes covered the book, that was the place where a lot of my peers went, oh, wait, hold up, wait.
Now, what was now the book? They're jumping on the
it was called The Pensado Papers. And it was me and Dave, and it was about the story of Pensado's place. Because inside the audio world, we became very hot very quick, and we've been hot for 5 years. Literally, in the audio space, I want to be careful about this, but there are certain places where we're kind of like the Beatles. Like if we walk into a studio, oh no, it's Dave and Herb. And that's been a weird also part of this, because I spent my career as a manager making other people big. Mm-hmm. And then when you turn the lights on yourself, you got to have to sort of have your feet planted to manage that. Cause I got recognized on the way over here. Herb, love the show. Nice. And that happens a lot.
Wow.
That's great.
So blessings, since there's a gospel circumference around this, you better believe it. Humbled hugely. A lot of work. Yep. We put an hour of programming on each week that is seen by a lot of people.
What day do you air?
Well, we post when we're ready. We used to air live, and we would have people able to watch the raw feed. We changed that about year two. I changed it because it was too dependent on the guest arrival. So if I had if I had Chad Smith from the Red Hot Chili Peppers or Rafael Sadiq or a big songwriter or a big engineer, and they couldn't get there till two, mm-hmm. I'm not going to not do the show. So we shoot the show, we edit overnight, clean things up, and then we post the next day when we're ready to post.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm.
So generally we try to stay on the Tuesday to Wednesday cycle. Sometimes we'll go to Thursday if we're on location or if we're doing whatever. If we have crews, we have files coming in from different places. But that's generally the cycle. Yeah. So
wonderful.
And yeah. I like the part about just, I guess you didn't say it was a fear associated with it, but when you realize that the product had to work with you attached to it.
Oh, scared to death.
Were you scared to death? So what helped you over those fear hurdles of walking into change, walking into something that's outside the box
of
your comfort zone?
I think that desperation is a great author. You know, sometimes you look it up and go, I started this show. Well, I came up with the idea. I was 55. My partner is 9 years older than me. So the last place you'd think two seniors would be is on the internet. That's number one. Secondly,
wrong.
It's just true. And I'll tell you about a story I had with Netflix, and they talked to me about that. The second thing was, I came up in an era where you didn't necessarily have feedback from everybody about what you did, right? So when I managed Brian McKnight, we put out a record. You either liked Back at One or you liked him or you didn't like him or whatever the case may be. But it wasn't coming back to me. So I didn't – I mean, it was coming back to me, but not directly
about
to
you.
Me. Yeah,
yeah,
and certainly not exactly, not about you. So the whole notion of me being on the web, talking and being in there and having comments back, I didn't know that I wanted that. And I think the lesson to answer your question is the fear stuff makes you better. And sometimes you got to step up in it. You got to lean – up in it. So, you know, somehow in my career, I've had all difficult projects. I've never had anything easy. It's, you know, Brian, when I managed Brian, was a very complicated thing because he was a jazz singer, really, and I turned him into a pop star and all this kind of stuff. There was other kinds of interesting things I had to do as a manager. Even artists that I liked that didn't become really big, but we had a big effort. There's a neo-soul artist named Cherokee that had a lot of stuff going on with her and billboard campaigns and stuff on television. We sold two records, but we had big campaigns. We sold two records.
Two records.
Her mama and
her aunt.
It wasn't her aunt. I think it was an ex-boyfriend of her mom's.
Oh, no.
But we did some great stuff. We had a lot of label support and Whitney Houston. Our band was so good. Whitney called and took the band. So I've always had these things that had some extra sort of twist to it. I've never had easy things. I think I'm stimulated by it. So this was kind of that challenge. How do I do this, and how do we make it interesting, and how do we get an hour of content on stuff I don't necessarily understand? So for the first year, I was just like a tennis match. I was going, looking back and forth, I was going, I don't know what these people are talking about, but I got to act like I know what they're talking about.
That's hilarious.
What is rolling off 2K? I don't know what 2K means. Is that $2,000? Is that a frequency? Could you explain a frequency to me? So there was that, but for me it was fulfilled by the notion of being a showrunner. You know, I had a television show to produce. I had marketing to do with that television show. I had goals to reach. We got sponsors pretty early. I had the kind of customer service with sponsors. I wanted to make that a very sophisticated thing and not just make it on clickbait and stuff. I had to learn digital media. The other place, just to be fair, because it's not all about me. Dave is an incredible part of the show, and we set the show up not to be his show. We set the show up to be Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. So I worked very hard on making sure he had his profile, I had my profile, our producer had his profile, our corner office guy had his profile, because my branding sensibility is that let me give the audience something to hold on to, and then I'll have a broader audience.
Right.
So it was never about just engineers either. It was about audio, never about just recording engineers, because if you think about it that way, there's no place in the world that's silent. Mm. That means audio's everywhere.
Right.
So we have people from ADR and Foley and gaming and television and movies. We have doctors who want to come on who use audio to detect healthy cells versus cancer cells. We have an event in Nashville every year called Gear Expo. I had somebody come on do audio forensics on how to solve crime using audio. Had audio in sports. So I've never looked at it like that.
So you're diversifying your audience options.
I think you have to when you do what we do.
Yeah,
sure.
When you do what we do, I think you have to.
When you were a little boy, what was your dream?
Ooh, wow. I had a weird upbringing in that my father was a prominent athlete, and I was junior. So I was born in, my father was the Jackie Robinson of the Canadian Football League. He broke the color barrier. He's in the Hall of Fame and all that kind of stuff. So I was Herb Jr., but I didn't realize I was Herb Jr. I was just a kid. I was like, I don't know why we're getting all this attention, Daddy. Mm-hmm. They're just attention, attention, attention. And I was born the year after he retired. So the answer to that is the way I kind of came in was sort of odd. I was like, what's all this attention thing? There's parts of this that feels good, and there's parts of this. So I think there was early imprinting about go for yours, kind of. Like I saw the after effects of my father's popularity and stuff, and it was kind of cool. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, I'm Junior? Okay, hey.
I can roll like this.
I'm Herb Junior. How are you? Junior? What's your name? So I think, honestly, my dream when I was a kid was that I wanted the majority of my business when I graduated from college to be focused on something I created. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know it was that deep back then, but I knew thinking those thoughts when I was young was really important. And kind of all the way through, now that I look back on it, when we did the Legends thing, you know, the funny thing is you have to look back at your career. And I was kind of flabbergasted. I was like, either I'm really old because I've done so much.
Yeah.
But you don't think about what you're doing until you're doing it. And then you catalog it and you go, oh, wow. Like, I've just had these incredible blessings. And consequently, now I kind of get up every day and work on something of my own, which is which I've done for a long time. It is a blessing. It's freedom.
When you say something of your own, what do you mean?
I own Pensado's Place with Dave. Before that, I had my own management companies, which I owned. I haven't had a corporate job. Well, when I was with Maurice, that was a job. But I was a partner with him for about 4 or 5 years. So I haven't really had a job for a while.
Congratulations.
Oh, Jesus.
We looked forward to entering that world.
Oh, Jesus.
It's like slavery.
Well,
it is.
And it's funny because there's two sides to that. There are times, you know, when you sat at the table with when we got the Legends thing, the category was creative visionary. And I tell people all the time, and by the way, I think I got that mostly because of Pensado's Place. Mm. When I talked to David Linton, chairman of it, he said, you know, you qualified in so many areas, and other areas were like, you know, digital media or executive and so on and so forth. And I think those would have been for the record parts of my career, but because of Pensado's success. So part of that whole creative visionary problem is you have vision and you can see, but sometimes you can see the train when it's coming at you about to mow you down.
Right, right.
So I tell people all the time, the freedom of being an entrepreneur is amazing. The grind of it is not for everybody.
No, it is not for the faint of heart.
It's not even for the strong heart.
You have to be so disciplined because making your own hours. Woo. You're your own boss.
Mm. You have no hours. It's 24 hours.
24 hours.
It's 24 like, hours. But you have to be disciplined in doing what it is you need
to do. And when we sat, it was 2 years ago, we sat at the Living Legends Award. We were at the back table. I felt like we had crashed.
Right.
We had crashed. We were in the back, you know. And like sitting there seeing it all play down, you probably had no idea. I was like 2 years later, then you're on the platform.
No idea.
And we were there just admiring everyone that was getting honored. And I was like, wow. We were cutting up in the back too.
We were cutting up
in the back. Oh my goodness.
For me, it was I'm a dreamer type. Mm-hmm. And it was the embodiment of a dream.
Right.
And, you know, when I came out to L.A. in 78, I had a lot of dreams. When I was working downtown at the L.A. Times part-time, and I'd go to RCA because I worked for Apple temporary agency because I was going to get in the record business one way or the other.
Okay.
And you just dream and you dream and you dream. And I was sneaking into the Brotherhood Crusade concerts and helping them put stuff up. And you dream and you dream. And all my whole journey has been either being ready for the opportunity when it comes up, you step through it, or dreaming about it and trying to create it. And then the part of the journey that all of us know is that you also get your head slapped all the time. Mm. It is not all success. There are plenty of failures.
Right.
You crash and burn, and it's how you pick yourself back up.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? And then you fight forward. And some best ones have picked themselves back up, but it hasn't lasted. So you learn you can't take it for granted. I can't take this for granted. I don't want to have to go do something else. I need to be ready just in case. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But so I think the Legends thing for me, when you think you're in, well, when you've been granted opportunity to be part of a club that includes people like Quincy Jones, Clarence Avant, I don't even have to go farther than that. Like, really? Like, you know, so for me, I remember I drove downtown when I heard about it, because when I used to drive downtown the other direction, go to LA Times, I used to dream about, like, God, will I ever do anything in the show business? Mm. And, you know, I would go to the LA Times at 5 o'clock in the morning and hear people screaming at me because their paper was wet and missing. Going, I got a dream. I'm going to make it. I heard what Martin said. I'm going to make it. And when I got the award, was, you know, a couple months ago, I drove downtown at night one night because I do a lot of driving, do a lot of my thinking in my car. And I was like, they can't take that one away from you.
That's right.
Whatever you've done, give us more.
Thank you.
How integral and important has faith been on your journey?
Big. Was raised in a very religious home, and had my mother was experimentally religious, which was not. So what that means is, let me break it down for you. So I was born in Canada, was a Baptist. My parents divorced, and a little bit because of the church, because my mom was going to make sure the church got theirs. You got grocery money? We need to tithe. My dad was going to tithe. Can you? So anyways, all that happened. So we went to Kentucky, which is where my parents were from, where they met. So when you're a kid who's a Canadian and you land in Kentucky in the middle of the civil rights movement, I was going, mother, mother, why are they calling me the N-word, mother? And I was like, oh, Lord, what is this? So we went from being Baptist to being Southern Baptist, except my mother wanted to expose me to all kinds of religions. So my mother was the wild trailblazer in Kentucky would say, come on, we're going to go to a different church. And she would head out to the backwoods of Kentucky. We'd be the only two black people in there. These people would be in there with snakes and all kinds. No, it was like all those kinds of. And I was like, mother, mom, it got to mom by that point. Mom, we don't need to do this. Like, right. I know I love Jesus, and Jesus in this form, I don't need to
cut off the chicken's head.
I don't need to do all that. And then she'd send me to like church Bible camps. I'd be the only black person there, and racism would raise its head. And I'd go, hey, mom, you know, camp is cool, but this kid just hit me in the stomach. So, and by the way, I just knocked him out. I just want you to know. But I love the Lord.
Right.
So all that faith was implanted early. And whether at church or not, it's always been a sort of part of my life. And it just feels present and comfortable. Okay. So, yeah. So, I'm here by grace. And I take none of it for granted.
And had a dream come true. Yay. Because you wanted to get in the record business. And
I did.
Did you always want to manage?
No. I didn't know I wanted to be in the record business. I came out here with a broadcasting degree, worked at KNX News Radio for a while. and I'm a reader, and I saw where record promotion people got a car and $60,000 a year and an expense account. I went, oh, bet. Okay. Right. That's what I want to do, because they didn't have any of that Kentucky. Mm-hmm. So I want that, whatever that is. And then, and much of what happens in my life, there was some beautiful woman who worked upstairs at KNX FM, which allowed me, because the other concept I couldn't get behind, because I love music so much, is you could get free records from promotion people. So I was like, "What? Well, wait, hold it.
Not now.
If I take the elevator upstairs, I get go through free records at the FM radio station, and there's a gorgeous woman there too.
Wow.
So let me just do that on my lunch break a lot. Sure. We end up living together for like 3 years, but that's another story. But I met local record people, and then they would tell me about it, and I began to sort of envision where I could potentially fit in. Didn't really realize I had a creative side at that time, and I went in as a promotion person at Solar Records at the time. And it was one of the most amazing journeys I've ever had. But I switched pretty quickly from the promotion side to more of the creative and deal-making side. I was a terrible promotion person. I was awesome.
Well, you're a better journalist, right?
The management came after the record side, so.
Yay. So I was trying to get in. I was like, you got 4 minutes. So I before we have to close out, I wanted to bring it back to how everything, your journey as in I guess starting at the LA Times, through the management opportunities, through, you know, the faith building that your mother instilled in you, and through the promotions aspect of it and your record label aspect of it, has all culminated into what you're doing today, Pensado's Place TV. For those who are not engineer mixers, I know you shared a little bit of some of the variety of content. Why should we tune into pensadosplace.tv?
Well, this is what the audience will tell you, or what they've told us. Somehow, some way, Dave and I are entertaining, and we're kind of funny. Most of my friends are non-audio people, and they'll listen to it because they find something interesting in it. Every week we have a guest that probably influenced heavily a record or music that you like. So whether we have on somebody with Justin Bieber's new record, or somebody who did The Weeknd, or somebody who did for 289 episodes, we've had somebody of that caliber each and every week, whether U2's guy or Bruno Mars guy. And I think that it's interesting to see what it takes to listen to the things you take for granted. So what you have on your headphones, like what we're listening to right now, I can tell you how that was mixed. And when you see the guy who mixed it, and you go, I didn't even know they were thinking about that. They got to me like that. There's a whole science in that craft that that we tapped into. Has worked out so pretty good so far.
Wow, ladies and gentlemen, Herb Trawick.
Oh, black man with a job. That's all.
Not a place.
Black man with a job.
Thank you so much.
Living legend.
Oh, no, it's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you for having
me. This is
me.
GospelRhythms.com, Talk Live Radio on LATalkLive.com. We got 2 minutes left. We got 2 minutes. Let's milk it, Dolly.
All we got.
All right, that's a good thing. So go ahead. I know you have some more questions.
No. I wanted to bring it back to Posado's place because we were closing out. He was giving us the minute warning. And I know you throw in a question to be off for 2 days. Yes.
All good.
Yes.
You got to come by Media Center sometime.
Yes.
We got our own television studio. Got a lot of stuff.
Give your websites. Give everything. How they can get in touch with you.
PosadosPlace.tv is the site. We have our own YouTube channel. And
you have a contest going on. You got 2 days. What is it? 29th? 11/29?
We do a deal with Converse and Indaba. It's a community of 1 million people, and we do mixed contests. Last time we did one, I think 578,000 people checked into the contest.
Wow,
it's crazy.
How do you go through all that content?
I don't.
Another show.
You hire really smart social media people.
Wow.
You can't do it without it.
Wow.
So we got blessed. So it's not just me, not just Dave. We had a third wheel, a social media guy that made the difference. And now we've just changed that team. Can't do it by yourself. Not to go to scale.
So if someone was to say, give good advice to people that are doing it like Ro and I, you would say definitely have a good social media team. And what else?
Well, the social media team is not just a social media team. It's a social, in you guys' case, you need a social media team from Gospel who speaks to your listener because they live it. You can just plug somebody else in. There's plenty of people you can plug in, but they don't always connect to how you do it. Then you have to understand it's a relationship. So you got to do this every day, or somebody's got to be doing it on your behalf. You have to have a strategy to build, not a strategy to views. It's not about clicking through and views. There's a strategy to building. There's a strategy to getting paid. There's a strategy to all of this.
Oh, we want to talk offline on that. Yes, we got a meeting right now.
About to have a revival.
We're about to have a revival. Touch up in heaven. Yeah. Praise God.
Everybody, we have had Herb Trawick in the house, and we are so appreciative of him coming.
Milo, thank you for hanging out, girl.
Thank you,
Richard. Thank you, Richard Nash. He created all of this. Thank you.
Richard stuck around, too. So, hey. All right, you guys, we'll see you next Sunday, 4 p.m. All right, that's BST.
Yeah.
Trisha Mann Grant.
Joe Williams.
Gospel Rhythm. Take it easy.
Cool.
And, of course,
thank you for having me.
There is an RTG in our
in it. You don't gotta chase dreams. You need to check us out and see what we mean.
Cast a vision.
Okay. Rappers, spoken word, and actors, and business owners, playwriters, and pastors, and many gifts to encourage the body. Consider this an invitation, come and kick it and party.
Thank you for tuning into LA Talk Live and the Talk Live Broadcast Network, original reality radio, and crafted for your listening and viewing pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk. Stay tuned.